Millions dream of fame, success, and life in the spotlight. But few realize what it takes to make it to the top. We're back for Series 3.
Good morning, everybody.
Inside one of the most famous stage schools in Britain. This is London's Italia Conti Academy of Theatre Arts, where as well as having normal lessons like maths and English, pupils learn to sing, dance, and act like professionals. And it's here that for some of them, dreams of a career on screen and stage really can come true. It's going to be a term of tough testing exams.
I can't believe how quick the GCSEs have actually come round.
Life-changing auditions.
Remember the audition for EastEnders? You've been offered the role.
Spectacular performances. And every pupil will be competing for a role in the huge end-of-year show.
Fight for it.
This is what life is like for those really seeking the big time. This is the School for Stars. Previously on School for Stars, Kedar proved a big acting hit on the set of CBBC show Wolfblood. But will Mark be as impressed with his dancing? Now he's fighting for a place in the end-of-year show.
I've been in Newcastle for 3 months. Going to Mark Webb's isn't the best.
After struggling to keep up when she first started at the school...
I did, it's just that I got confused on which way to go.
Has Paris finally got her first big break?
There's your script. It's for a part, Zakia.
I'm going to be really, really nervous because I've never done an audition before.
And having won a scholarship at the school, will a full-time place be more than Sadie bargained for?
I've done something really wrong. I feel really, really stupid.
It's the summer term at the School for Stars, and the first day back can often make people nervous, especially if you're one of the newest pupils, like 12-year-old Sadie.
Sort of really worried, because obviously I haven't got that much training. I started when I was 10, and like there's people who start dancing when they were 3, and they know what the deal is, they know how high the standards are. So, I don't know, it's a bit... mixed feelings I have today.
But Sadie's mum is the one person who can reassure her.
You'll be fine. You've been doing this on Saturdays for how long? Maybe 2 years?
No, a year and a half.
But
no,
you...
it is 2. No.
Right, you'll be fine.
What if the people there are like better than me and not as good as them?
You just gotta be Sadie, do what Sadie does. Sadie, you've got nothing to worry about.
The headmaster of the school is Mr. Vogt, and the welcome back assembly is an ideal time to talk about what the summer term holds.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning,
Ted. Ah, super to see you all back again. Right, okay. To say that this term is dominated by examinations is a bit of an understatement, really, because we have just got them from everybody from every quarter. You've got ballet, you've got tap, you've got modern examinations, you've got singing, lambda exam, and of course GCSEs. For poor year 11s. And of course, at the end of term, we have got our whole entire academy show.
Right, okay, up you get.
Sadie's nerves aren't being helped by the fact that she's running late and has already missed assembly.
See you later, love you.
But with just enough time to say a quick goodbye to Mum, she rushes to find out her timetable.
Hello.
Hello.
What's on Friday?
What's
that? Singing audition
prep. That's new.
What? Missed assembly because the train's late, but I've got my timetable and I've got acting, jazz and ballet, and I'm really happy about that, so quite excited now.
As Year 10 student Max settles back into school, he has a solo dance exam coming up. And although he's had heaps of time over the holidays to practice, he hasn't prepared anything for his teacher to see.
You know, I've got this modern exam in 2 weeks, yeah? I haven't got a dance. And you know how bad I am at dancing. I'm not bad, but, you know, I struggle with it, so... I just kind of... When I make up some choreography, I just absolutely stupid doing it, you know? So, I need to... Because, you know, like, when you taught me dances before, they've been good, so...
Yeah, and then we'll see if Miss Hawkins likes it. Or she can, so she has something to work with. We'll get in at 8 o'clock tomorrow and we'll start. Gives us 45 minutes to just rehearse, really.
So with good friend and bandmate Luca on board to help, Max is hoping to create a last-minute dance from scratch. As Sadie settles in, she shares classes with pupils who have a range of abilities. And keeping up with them is proven just as tough as she imagined.
My splits aren't my strong point. I can do them if I, like, really, 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 really warm up. But just gotta keep trying, keep stretching. Hopefully I'll be able to do the splits by next week.
Someone who knows better than anyone about what it's like to be a pupil here is old-timer Reese.
So how are you guys getting on with your GCSEs? Going good? I feel it's going okay, but there's definitely, like, a few areas where I need to sort of get better.
Yeah, then you need to do some more revising.
You haven't done any revising. It's like... Do you think that you're on top of all the exams?
I think I'm like mid-way. Yeah. I need to revise a bit more.
I've got all the basic facts, but I need to put those facts into questions, I think. Hopefully we all do well. I think it's just a thing of just wanting to do well so you can make a mum and everyone just proud of you. Like, they sent you to school and you come away with something, you know?
It's only halfway through the first day back, but has Sadie already made her first big mistake?
I've done something wrong. I'm supposed to do jazz now, but I've just done jazz instead of acting, and I didn't know. Now I'm really, really confused. Oh, I've mixed them up.
Just tell Miss Elson that you muddled it up. She ain't
tell
Miss Elson
what? She's here.
All right. Are you doing that?
Are you going to
get changed?
I don't know. Miss Elson, I've done something really wrong. I feel really, really stupid.
What have you done?
Because we usually have jazz first. I read the timetable. Oh.
Yeah? It's
yeah, okay. I've switched them. I'm sorry.
Okay. So you know now
that
you've got acting with me first?
Yeah.
It's all right. Don't worry.
Could I possibly do your class now?
Would you like
please?
To?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Sadie may have avoided a telling off this time, but she's learning fast that there's little room for error if she's going to be successful here.
Today was okay. A few minor hiccups, but it was okay. It was good.
Max has arrived at school early to try and work out a routine in time for this morning's class.
I'm just practicing my modern dance for my exam, and I'm just waiting for Luca to come because he's meant to be here at 8, but he's late. So, yeah.
And from the looks of things, Luca's help couldn't arrive too soon.
Ah, crap, what was it there? Oh, yeah.
All Max needs to pass his exam is a 60-second dance routine. While Max loves to sing and perform, dancing just isn't his thing.
Is that all on the...
So, yeah, so you've got 4, 7, 8, that's what it is.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Kick off. Just jump onto that foot.
Onto what, this one?
Yeah, just, yeah, like that, but take this one off. So instead of going like that, just like that, just jump it. Jump on it. Yeah,
just get up. But I just look, I feel like a... an old man doing it.
Do it by yourself so I can see it.
Do it by myself?
Yeah.
What if I muck up?
It doesn't matter. Just go again.
I think it might be the way forward. What is it? Yeah. Is it that fast? Oh, okay. Hang on, what time is that? Cheers, Luca. I can make the other 30 up at home or something. I guess.
The school is home to 275 pupils aged 11 and up, and it's helped megastars like Leona Lewis and Pixie Lott on their road to success.
Hi, guys.
Hi, how are you?
In order to get professional work, every pupil here is offered representation by the school's agency, which is on the top floor and run by Anna.
Basically, my job is to find the students on the books work in the industry. I'm about to go down to find Paris and Bessy for a casting that they have for television, a television role. So there's their scripts, and now I'm going to go and find them.
Today it's the turn of friends Paris and Bessy to get a visit from Anna.
Sorry to interrupt.
You need...
Can I talk to Bessy in Paris, please? Can you come up to the agency after you finish your class?
OK, you too.
Thank you.
I'm really excited. I mean, I hope it's an audition for something good that you get paid for.
I think it's probably an audition, but I'm not sure. I hope it's an audition because they're good. I'm really excited.
I hope it's not something like, oh, you forgot to pay your agency fee.
If this is an audition, I'm going to be really, really nervous because I've never done an audition before. And even worse, it would be against, like, one of my friends, Bessy. And so it could be really awkward if one of us gets it and then the other one doesn't.
Hi, girls. Come in.
Anna and the school's agency have already bagged a professional role for Year 7's Tommy. But juggling school with a role in London's West End isn't always easy. And performing a matinee on a weekday means he's often in a hurry.
In the first 3 weeks of coming here, the agency asked me to do an audition for Singing in the Rain in the West End. And I'm currently doing it now. And it's, like, amazing to be on the West End, because that's, like, what my dream was ever since I was about six. I've been coming to school for about 3/4 of a year now, and, like, it's really fun because I'm finding it, like, it's just amazing to be here.
Sorry I'm late. Train delays because, yeah. No, I'm not actually late much, but it's just that, like, today it has to be the day. When I'm practicing my exam, I have to be late.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Drop shuffle, drop shuffle, drop shuffle, step.
Exam people, on the pick-up ball change, can you try and have a flat foot? 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, and 2, and 3, and a flat. Better. Okay, George, just swap place with Tommy because he's got his exam. So, last week we did drop, pick up, drop, pick up, drop, pick up, toe, ball change, didn't we?
Yeah.
Tommy's going to demonstrate for us. Ready? Yeah, nice, good, well done.
And then it goes singing and acting, because I'm not too keen on acting, because I'm not very good at picking up the words, like learning words and everything.
Tommy's enthusiastic. He'll take away what you've said to him, he'll process it, and he'll come back the next week and he will have practiced it. He went away on the Easter holidays and he must have done quite a lot of practice because he came back and he really did know what he was doing.
both have castings for... Do you watch a programme called The Dumping Ground?
Yeah, I love that. Yeah.
Well, that's what the cast is for. You need to watch it. You're covered.
Oh, I love it so much.
It's for CBBC, so it's a very nice part. There's your script. It's for a part, and the part is Zakia. So that's yours, Bessy. There's your script.
Mm-hmm.
And that's your time and where you're going to.
Okay.
So if you can, because it's on Saturday, try and learn as much as you can.
Okay.
So it just looks nicer if you can do some of it off book. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Paris, there's your same part, so you're in competition. When you've read the character brief, sort of go, if you can, sort of dress like you think they might dress and that sort of thing. You can practice together.
Yeah, she said that already.
So best of luck, and then let me know how it goes. I'll keep my fingers crossed for you on Saturday.
Thank you.
Thank you, bye.
Bye.
Have a good time.
I'm really excited because it's my first audition.
Woo! Yay! I always say to the student, you can only do the best you can do. But I do expect you to do the best you can do.
I think we have to roughen up, be like,
yeah, what up, fam? Yeah, I went to the shops, yeah, and I bought some McDonald's.
Max's dance teacher, Miss Wilkins, isn't impressed with his lack of preparation, and she's on the warpath.
I'm looking for Max.
Max has a modern dance exam soon, and he should have prepared one little piece for me, one solo. That's all. I've done all the rest of the work. He's just got to do that one solo himself. If Max hasn't been practicing, I will be very angry. He should have been practicing. I really hope he has been practicing. I'm now going to go and see if I can find him in the canteen and find out. Max. Where's Max?
In English.
Max, I'm looking for Max. Come on, Max. Please tell me you've been working.
Yeah.
Lots?
Yeah, with Luca. We were getting it at 8 o'clock, so it's fine.
Excellent.
So I've turned to work.
So when am I going to see it?
It's up to you.
4:30?
4:30, yeah, okay.
You come and find me?
Yeah, I will, yeah.
With your iPod that's working?
Yeah, with my iPhone that's working, of course.
We look forward to it.
Okay.
Fingers crossed.
For Paris and Bessy, their audition is big news, and friends are there to give them some advice.
Do you have to learn a script for the audition?
Yeah.
How long is it? Is it like?
It's 5 pages long, but like, it's not all Zakia speaking, so it's fine. I think it's 3 scenes. I really don't know what to wear though.
I think you should wear your own clothes to try to show your personality more. Whatever the character is, if it says the character's quite quiet, then I go in something a bit more settled. But if it says the character's like quirky, then I go in something a bit more like outgoing.
Yeah. Oh yeah, and we can't be posh.
Can't be posh.
Can't be posh.
I think you just need to be yourself.
Yeah.
Smile or not.
It's Saturday morning, and the day of Paris and Bessie's audition for a part in the Tracy Beaker spin-off, The Dumping Ground.
Don't be nervous. We've practiced enough. Just kind of rest your voice till the main
audition. Yeah.
I think I'm more nervous than you.
I don't think you are.
Oh, I am. Trust
no, you're not.
I am very nervous.
With their parents just as anxious as they are, the girls have planned to meet up beforehand to calm their nerves. But Paris has had extra cause for concern.
My voice is getting better.
Yeah, it is. It was really bad yesterday morning. It was like,
hello. Come to the dark side.
How unfair is that, though, that my first audition, I've got a sore throat?
Yeah, it's kind of unfair.
My voice has gotten a lot better since yesterday, but it's still really rough. The worst thing that could happen is that my voice kind of goes and then I can't speak.
I don't really know how to say, like, the first line, because I don't know, because it's...
What, the first scene?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm nervous about that, too.
It's like, I'm sorry, I tripped, but then are you supposed to trip, or is she just like...
Oh, I'm going
to
trip. Oops.
And you fall over and break something. I have done quite a few auditions before, but I don't think I'm a pro yet, so I am obviously nervous.
but I am also really excited because it's the dumping ground and everyone wants to be in that.
Paris and Bessie's audition is held in a private house where access is highly restricted, meaning our cameras are banned. As they make their way to their audition, all they can do now is give it their best shot. Karen is head of musical theatre at the school, and the end of year summer show she organises is something every pupil wants to be involved in.
Guys, as quickly as you can you come and sit down for me, please?
We are obviously straight now into your show rehearsals. So everything you are doing in your lessons, even if it's not a show number that you are rehearsing, you have to understand that you are working on your stamina, on your technique, everything else. So I do not want to hear, do we have to go to ballet? Do we have to go to tap? Do I have to go there? But I'm not in that number. I don't want to hear that at all. You need to be responsible for looking and being the best that you can possibly be. And you can only do that if you get to your lessons. So please, everything you do from this minute, you need to really focus towards your summer show. So audition-wise, in your classes, in your musical theatre classes, you are going to be auditioned right the way through today. So please, 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 no one coming in. Can I do it again? Can I just, I know I can do it better. Do it fabulous the first time, okay?
And one person keen to shine in the end of year show is Kedar. He's been hard at work on the hit CBBC series Wolfblood, but he's back to school now and hoping to win a role in Mark Webb's routine for the end of year show. Featuring the school's top dancers, it's the routine all the seniors want to be seen in.
About to go into Mark Webb's audition for the summer show. I've been in Newcastle for 3 months, just came back. Well, I came back on Thursday last week. So back here now, getting back into college and stuff. Just getting back into the swing of things. It's good. It's hard. The most exercise I've done in 3 months is walking up and down stairs. So just going to Mark Webb's isn't the best, but getting back into it is fun, I guess.
I'm looking for 7 girls, 7 boys. I'm looking for team players, and I want to give people, for me personally, someone that's going to be here every week and someone that I can depend on and someone that wants to be here and do it and give me heart and soul. Yeah? Thank you. Boys.
During the audition, Mark will be looking for dancers who can learn the routine quickly, but more importantly, who can deliver it the best.
In the club, uh-huh, dropping light. Dominoes dropping like dominoes. Good.
After months away from dance classes, it's not easy to keep up with Mark's instructions.
Hey. All the boys, ah, ah. Again.
Mark's only looking for 7 boys for this dance number, so Kedar has to up his game.
Right, you want to be in the business, let's go. One more.
Kedar is trying his hardest, but will it be enough for the school's toughest teacher?
Fight for it. Always remember, fight, mate. Don't leave the door thinking, I could have got more. Heart and soul, do you stand? Fight for it, yes? Yeah. Fight for it, want it.
And Kedar isn't the only person fighting for a role. Paris and Bessie haven't seen each other since their dumping ground audition at the weekend.
Hey. Oh, hey, Paris.
Hey. How did it go?
It went really well, I think.
How was yours?
It went really good.
Like, she let me do the whole of it, so I guess that's good.
Yeah. She made me do the first one twice, though.
Yeah, she made me do that. I think she made me do it 3 times. Like, she went back on it again. I was like, okay.
How many people were there?
There was, like, one girl when I got there, but then another girl went out.
And then there was like another two when I got out, so there were quite a lot of people.
There was one girl when I was waiting, and then there was another girl that was waiting that was after me. So that's, and there's only two people.
So I guess like there's loads of people auditioning, so it's a bit...
They said they liked my husky voice. I was like, huh? Right. Yeah, they were like, so is your voice, because I told them I have a cold, they were like, so is your voice normally like that? Is it different? Is it basically the same? And I was like, yeah, it's only a tiny bit different.
What up? Fantastic.
After an exhausting audition, it's time for Kedar to find out if he's impressed Mark enough to get a lead in his prestigious routine.
Congratulations, everybody. You did fantastic today. Stay for me. 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 Thank you, everybody else.
Sadly, it's a no for Kedar this time.
Thank you. Well done, everybody else. Kedar, you know, he's a great lad. He's got a lovely energy about him, but obviously he's been away and he's been filming. So, of course, he's going to be a bit rusty. He's been doing his series and, you know, he coped with it all right. But it's like if you don't go to the gym every day and then you decide to go after a year, you're not going to be able to do it properly. So for me, you know, he needs to get back in class and he needs to, you know, pull up a little bit more, really.
Mark didn't choose me for this number. I haven't been here for so long. And I mean, there's like the boys who've been here for like nearly 3 months doing it every week, pushing would obviously have more better chance than me, so.
I salute every one of you. Because even yourself, you've been off, you stayed with it. So I salute that. Do you know what I'm saying? It's not today, it's about tomorrow. So if this one don't happen for you, chin's up, what do we do with the negative energy? We turn it to a positive. This is a learning curve. Do you understand? Yeah?
Since auditioning, Bessy and Paris sadly never heard back from the casting producers. But along with Kedar, they're learning all too quickly that rejection is just part of the show business world. With even more hard work, dedication, and a positive attitude, tomorrow could bring something bigger and better. Next time on School for Stars,
okay.
It's showtime for Max and Miss Wilkins. Tilly is feeling the pressure.
I never really cry. I'm feeling so much pressure right now.
And Tommy takes on some of the best that the school can throw at him.